What's going on, guys? This is Malcolm. You're back on Malcolm Talks once again, and I do appreciate you guys visiting the channel. Today is going to kind of be a ramble, but I want to talk about black on black crime. Yeah, that's what I want to talk about. I want to talk about all of it, man. All of it. You know, because see, these issues have roots. And a lot of the roots go so deep, it's hard to see them now. You got to be able to dig up all kind of dirt to get to the bottom of these things. As a matter of fact, they're so deep, you might not ever be able to get to the bottom of them. Or if you do get to the bottom of it, you damn near jeopardize killing a tree. But you know, when it comes to black on black crime, you know, people always talk about that. But then they say, well, it's all about proximity. You know, depending on where you live or whatever, you're just gonna do crimes against those who live closest to you. And that makes sense, right? And I don't have any statistics, and I'm pretty sure that would help in this conversation if I had real numbers and real statistics. But I can tell you right now that we have a problem in the African American community as it relates to crime. Not all communities, not all black communities are all communities of color, but some. Now, there are some people who, when they hear that, it makes them cringe. They feel like, you know what, man? I don't want to talk about that because there's so many reasons why that's the case. That unless we're willing to talk about the why, then I don't even want to hear about the fact that, you know, there was all of these shootings happening in Chicago or Atlanta or whatever the case may be. Like, they don't want to talk about that part of it unless you also bring up the historical roots. And what's going on, how, you know, the systematic oppression that has happened over the course of generations in this country for hundreds of years, guys. So the conversation always takes paths. It always takes paths. And see, the question is, are these issues already on a path? Or, because see, that's the problem. If we talk about, okay, there was, you know, there was 56 killings in Chicago. Majority of them were kids, like, you know, young teenagers. Okay, is that the root? Is that what we're going to talk about? Or is that problem, is it already on a path in terms of, is it part of a larger discussion? Or is it the starting point of the discussion? Because see, I think a lot of times, especially politicians, you know, a lot of times a politician will look at it as if that's the starting point of the discussion. Oh, we need to stop crime. We need to be tough on crime and get these criminals off the streets, you know. That sounds good, right? But it sort of assumes that it's not a branch of a larger tree. It makes it seem like it's the only issue we're dealing with right now. What it basically does is it doesn't take into account the larger picture. Now, when people are dying in the streets, something needs to be done about it. We can't sit back and be like, well, no, we need more Boys and Girls Clubs, and we need more this, and then we need more that. And while we're planning and doing all that, these people getting killed on the streets. Unfortunately, that can't happen. We're going to have to figure out a way to fix the airplane while we're in the air. And that can be extremely challenging. So, and I'm not really on here offering solutions. I'm not going to tell you what I think is going to fix the world's problems. or what's going to fix the problems of the African-American community. Every community has their own separate issues. I just think African-American issues are a little bit more acute. Now, you can disagree with that. You can agree with that, however you want to do it. We have a lot of good things happening in the African-American community, obviously. We have a lot of things that we need to improve. I think the first way to improve it, and like I said, this is just my opinion. The first thing to do to improve it is we have to figure out some type of way. We have to figure out why people are so angry. You know, why is there so much crime? Because we could say, well, no, it's crime because of poverty. Every time it's more poverty, that's where the crime comes from. And I'm pretty sure you can pull up statistics that'll show you where there's high poverty, no matter the nationality or ethnicity. Wherever there's more poverty, you're gonna find more crime. Now, that's true. However, I think if you also do a little bit more research, you'll find out that, well, in the African American community, if there's poverty, yes, there may be crime, but the crime is actually a little bit higher as a percentage of their population. And the question is, why? Why is that the case? Is it something about us? Is it something about black people that makes us more violent than your other ethnicities? Is it? Because that's what it looks like on TV. That's the way the picture can be painted. That's the way these biases form. You know, if you're looking at the numbers and you're like, well, there's a disproportionate situation going on, the first thing people do is they tend to jump to slavery, or they tend to jump to, you know, systemic racism. And I'm not saying any of those things are not true, but this just tends to be the default that they blame everything on. Like, systemic racism, police brutality is huge. I mean, you see that with your own eyes. But they, you know, people talk about that as if it's actually the reason for all the crime and things like that we see. And this has been going on for years. But you know, one thing that nobody ever really talks about, the music. Nobody ever talks about that. I mean, you got people here and they're talking about it, but I'm saying nobody ever really talks about it. Like, this is the cause of the killing. We don't talk about it like that. And I think the reason why is because, hey man, freedom of speech. Freedom of speech. You can't try to put a muzzle on the music now. The music is doing something to us, guys. When you listen to a beat, that's one thing. When you listen to the lyrics, that's another thing. When you listen to the lyrics from someone who is talking about criminal activity, or who was a criminal, who put his persona on the music, you're talking about something entirely different then too. If you get thousands and thousands of people, millions of people listening to that music in their car, that persona, and I know I'm going deep, guys, but that persona will rub off on you. Metaphysical things are happening within the body when you listen to rap music. Depending on the type of music, I think it will make you violent. There it is, I said it. If you listen to drill music, I think you're more likely to commit crime. Yep. Like it or not. But these are my opinions, remember now. I think if you listen to R&B music,